the mysterious God Cube. It was introduced in One Punch Man chapter 137 as Blast had rescued Tatsumaki, and then in the very next chapter, 138, as Saitama is digging out Flashy Flash, he finds a similar object, which appears to open a portal to some sort of abyss or some sort of God dimension where we see God himself in the fetal position. What is this God Cube? How is it related to Blast and Saitama? There's all sorts of theories, but it's definitely an important object as Murata is focusing on showing us this particular object, which was not in the One webcomic. In this video, I want to go over some facts between Blast, the God Cube, and God himself, talk about some speculations, and give some theories as to what this mysterious object may actually be. First, let's talk about some facts about the cube and God that we know of. Number one, the cube is extremely heavy. Even S-rank hero Flashy Flash could not take his arm out from underneath it, but Saitama was easily able to grab it and toss it. When he did, it landed in the ground, creating a crater. It was extremely heavy. And we also saw Blast, he was able to carry it with ease. We know that Blast is pretty damn powerful. He blew a giant hole through a monster, and his attack looked kind of similar to Saitama's. So presumably, only those who are worthy can hold this object. Perhaps it is like Thor's hammer. The second fact, it's an object of great importance. Murata is obviously trying to show us this cube on purpose. He wants us to be talking about it, and he wants it to have some correlation with God himself. After Saitama touched and tossed the cube, that's when the portal to the God dimension had opened. And the third fact that we know of is that God, seemingly trapped in a prison, can still somehow grant powers to those in the One Punch Man world from the abyss that he's locked in. Let's talk about some speculations. The first is that the cube is actually connected to God somehow. It gives the appearance that after Saitama touched and tossed it, that's when the portal to the God dimension opened, but that's not clarified yet. We don't know that for sure. Obviously, it could be some sort of key to the God dimension. Blast could have known about this. It could have been his main objective for even going to the research facility, but we don't know any of those as a fact as of yet. The second speculation is that the research facility that Tatsumaki was a prisoner in could definitely have had this object within, which was perhaps Blast's main objective instead of a rescue mission. Now, some people have speculated that maybe this is a weapon of Blast. Maybe he walks around with the cube and that's sort of like his artillery. But I'm thinking more so, he went to that research facility where Tatsumaki was held in order to acquire the cube. Now, in this research facility, they were doing tests on espers, so that leads me to believe possibly that they need espers in order to access the cube, hence Tatsumaki's imprisonment. Maybe they were collecting espers to access the God Cube's power, but that doesn't explain why after touching it, Saitama and Flashy Flash can now see God because they're not espers. The third speculation is that there may be multiple cubes. So the flashback between Tatsumaki and Blast was 18 years ago, and it's possible that this is the same cube that somehow in that time difference, it was moved down deep into the Monster Association, but it could also be possible that there are multiple cubes. The one that Blast had is probably not the same one Saitama found deep in the Monster Association, meaning that possibly you'd have to collect multiple cubes in order to open a portal big enough for God to escape that prison. But we also don't know for sure that it's a prison. It sure looks like it since God is in the fetal position, doesn't seem to be moving so much. Think about this. The one little cube that Saitama had opened this tiny little opening into the God realm. Maybe you need something like 100 cubes to open a portal big enough for God to actually escape. So it could be a piece of the key to freeing God to rain destruction on Earth. If there aren't multiple cubes, then perhaps at some point Psychos had found this object and she was doing experiments or studying it. She also is an Esper, so she may have some sort of tie to this cube, which may be the reason perhaps that she was able to get power from God. Homeless Emperor was also deep down in the Monster Association and God gave him powers, so they're pretty down deep and it may have something to do with the cube being down there, or it may be, have something to do with them just being so deep down in the earth. As we've speculated before, God may actually be earth itself, but that's seeming less likely now per this chapter. The fourth speculation. In a recent promo art for the One Punch Man manga, we see the monster tower and riches spread throughout different levels of this art. Now, there's a couple particular objects here which fans have taken note of. The first is a Pharaoh's head object, and the second is an object that looks like the Ark of the Covenant deep below the Monster Association. So perhaps this is a very ancient item. Perhaps it was something the Egyptians had. Perhaps ancient civilization attributed this cube to God itself. The fifth speculation is that this is an alien object. Perhaps it landed on Earth a very long time ago, but it also could have been created by some great scientist. We know there's a lot of very ingenious scientists in the One Punch Man universe, so it could have been created as some sort of key, if maybe a scientist was helping Blast to collect and use these to seal off God, because we have to understand the correlation between Blast and the God level threat. When they talk about Blast will only return for a God level threat, they may have been talking very literally there. The final speculation and concern is that the images we've seen from the visions of Psychos, for example, and the God we are seeing just now look pretty differently. However, as one Reddit user pointed out, what if the spherical planet that Psycho saw was just the top of his head? If you flip the image that Psycho saw and map it to the God's head, it actually does fit perfectly. And even here on this One Punch Man promo art, what if that's just perspective art and you're almost looking down on God? That could just simply be the top of his head. That would really show you the sense of scale at how massive this thing actually is. Meaning maybe the true form of God has always been this interdimensional humanoid being, and the God planet was just simply a piece of the top of its head. Now with all the facts and speculations in place, let's get to some theories. The first theory is that it's a piece of God himself. If it's actually a piece of God, that would explain both the weight and why when you touch it, you're able to actually see God. Meaning that if it's a piece of God, that there's going to be some sort of connection between both the God and the cube. The second theory is that these cubes are scattered around the world. Perhaps it's a key that you need multiple of to free him from the prison. As we said before, the one cube opened a tiny hole to his dimension, meaning you would need a whole lot of cubes to actually free him or release him onto the world. I believe Blast knew this, and it was his objective all along to keep this God imprisoned. And when we get to the arc where Saitama eventually fights God, I think that's when we're going to see Blast return as well. My theory is that Blast's main objective was to protect Earth from this threat entirely. Now, if Blast couldn't destroy the God, that means that God is probably indestructible. In C. Emming Lap's fan manga, it's an interdimensional being that can continually transform its body, essentially has control over matter itself. So if this God is indestructible, that means Saitama wouldn't be able to defeat it. Without a doubt, Blast and the cube and this God creature are connected, and that potentially could be the finale to this arc. My next theory is that Drive Knight is actually the traitor, and his main goal, his main objective as the real antagonist of this series is to release God onto the world, and he may be the one to do it. So as we've seen from Drive Knight, he goes around collecting things like pieces of Boros' spaceship. He wanted the Orochi monster cells. He definitely likes to experiment and gather information for some ulterior motive. My theory is that the final arc of the series will be Drive Knight collecting all of the cubes, if there is more than one, releasing God onto the world, and then it'll be up to Saitama and Blast to stop it. Now there's one huge question remaining. Now that Saitama is face to face with God, where do we go from here? We thought that God would potentially be the final enemy of the entire series, but now what happens? Do they just leave God alone and move on with the arc, following the webcomic as much as possible? Does Saitama simply jump in there, punch it, and then the arc goes on as usual? Does God awaken and circumvent the entire series? And now everything, including Garo, the cadres, the S-classes, and even Saitama have to fight with it. That would derail the entire series that follows the webcomic. Or, since we've seen so much Blast in the last few chapters, now that a portal has been opened, will Blast arrive and do something to shut that portal or just fight the God there itself? Spoilers for the webcomic, The Cadres are going to be fighting the S-rank heroes for a while, and then Garo is going to come up and fight as well. So there's still quite a few chapters, a lot of chapters, before Saitama is going to fight Garo. Meaning Saitama needs to be held underground somehow, leading me to believe that he very well may fight God right here. And if he doesn't, Blast may come and there may be some sort of mini arc with the monster god right there, but something is going to have to keep Saitama at bay while the Cadres and Garo fight. And that seems to be God itself. I don't think that would be too fitting, as it's so hyped up to be this mysterious being and a potentially world-ending threat that we would assume is the god-level threat they saw in the prophecies. He seems more of like an endgame final boss, so it would be a little strange to defeat him right here. But it's entirely possible. I'm Matt Star, thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys in the next video.